Yo, 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 what's good, fam? Welcome to PNP. It is your boy Rashad, one half of PNP, and today I'm giving y'all my top 10 cornerbacks of the 2022 NFL Draft, another supremely talented group. It was hard. I had to leave some guys out. It is what it is. You know, I want to hear y'all thoughts. Once you see the top 10, give me y'all thoughts on who I'm missing. I like to hear that because it's a lot of guys that may not have made this list, but could potentially be top 10 cornerbacks at the end of the day. All right. So before we get into it, make sure that like button, subscribe button, notification bell, get in the comments. Let me know what's good. I know I'm a Panthers fan, but we got a lot of draft content here. Some of the best on the tube. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button. We're trying to get to 50,000 subscribers by the end of the year. We got a long way to go. So I need y'all to hit that subscribe button. When the combine comes up, we're going to cover it live. When the pro days come up, we're going to cover it live. You can go back to see what we did last year. A lot of good content over here, man. So hit that subscribe button if you into this draft and you bought this draft life. All right, let's go ahead and get into it. Number 10. Coming in at number 10, we have Kobe Bryant, cornerback out of Cincinnati. RIP the real Kobe Bryant, but man, I believe this cat was named after him. Shout out to his mom. But man, 6'1", 198 pound cornerback out of Cincinnati, bro. Cincinnati had a great tandem of cornerbacks, okay? And he was one of them opposite of the Sauce, okay? So Sauce Gardner was the main guy. He was kind of Robin to Batman. And so this guy also had a great season. You know, playing opposite of a good cornerback like that, you're going to get targeted a lot. And he held his own. Not only that, he did a great job at the Senior Bowl as well. But let me just quickly introduce you to the stats that I'm going to run down for these cornerbacks. You know, I like to bring in the numbers to kind of match with the eye test. I'm not a guy that just goes off the eye. I go off of what the numbers tell me as well. It's important. You can't be too heavy on one side. You can't be heavy numbers. You can't be heavy eye test. You got to kind of marry the two. And that's what I try to accomplish. Sometimes I do get a little heavy into the numbers. I'm going to be honest. You know, just a flaw. I'll get better at that. But I do like what the numbers provide me. And then I also marry it with the eye test, and then I go from there. All right, so let's see what we got. We got the coverage grade. This is a courtesy of PFF, so shout out to PFF. I know some of y'all don't like PFF, but I love it. I'm able to use my eye test to kind of negate some of the bad stuff. But coverage grade, 85. Run defense, 83.6. Three interceptions, and these interceptions and stats from here below are for the 2021-2022 season. All right, so that's this current season. Three interceptions, 44% completion percentage, 61 passer rating when thrown at him, 12 forced incompletions, and then at the bottom you can see where this guy lined up, whether it was slot cornerback, you know, a boundary cornerback or outside cornerback, whether he's in the box or like a strong safety, or whether he was a deep or free safety. Very important to understand where these guys have experience at, because a lot of these guys may get moved to other positions. So it's very important to understand where he has experience at. And obviously, if you look at his number, I'm gonna be honest with y'all, that 2,390 snaps at outside cornerback is one of the most experienced guys in this top 10 list, okay? So let's go ahead and get into some strengths and weaknesses for said Kobe Bryant. Like, so again, with his size, he's gonna have the ideal length and size for the position. He's 6'1", 198 pounds. He's gonna have the nice arm length. Very good IQ for the game. He's got really good feet. He's got some mirror. He mirrors well. So when the wide receivers are doing all this janky stuff at the line of scrimmage, he's been able to mirror that pretty well. A pretty good tackler. Very good scrappy kid. And again, that NFL frame with good strong hands is going to help him out. So I like his game from a from an overall side. I think he has a lot of components that are going to translate to the NFL very well. As far as weaknesses go, he's not going to be the fastest guy in the world. He's got good speed, but that top end speed to kind of cover some of the faster guys in the NFL, he's not going to have that. So sometimes he does have issues getting off the blocks as well. So just a couple things that he needs, a couple nuances he can fix in his game. But again, he's one of the most experienced cornerbacks in this top 10 list. And I think he could go in the third or fourth round in the 2022 NFL draft. Let's move on. Coming in at number 9, we have Marcus Jones. Like, this kid, I didn't know much about him. I'm gonna be honest with y'all, but when I cut on the film, I do a lot of research. When it comes to these guys, I do a lot of research. That's why it takes me some time to put these out. I'm not just gonna putting them out off of whim. I really kind of put in the time to do the research on these guys. And this guy I liked a lot once I cut on the film. Again, I did not know much about him, but 5'8", 185 pounds, not the biggest dude in the world. Okay, it is what it is there. He's got a coverage grade of 86, his run defense 83, 5 interceptions on the season, completion percentage when thrown at 48.7%, passer rating of a 60.4 when thrown at, 16 forced incompletions. That's very solid. As you can see, he has a little bit of experience playing slot cornerback, played most at boundary cornerback, a little all over the place for Marcus Jones. Obviously, at his size, you're going to want to peg him at slot cornerback. So that's what we're going to see most likely. But the guy had a very good season in 2021, put up his best numbers as a cornerback where he recorded 40 tackles, obviously the 5 interceptions. Very good season. Also, he was handed first-team All-Conference honors as a return specialist and second-team honors as a cornerback. Yes, you heard it. This man can actually kick, return punts and kicks as well. Add that to the list. I've also seen him play on the offensive side of the ball when it comes to Houston as well. So this guy is a talented kid. He had, you know, he's got that prime time in him. He's playing all over the place, and I really like what I saw in his game when I cut on the film. Okay, strengths and weaknesses. Now, good athletic frame. This guy, he's gonna be able to run quick. He's gonna be able to run fast. He's got the return ability, so he's very, very good there. He's got good hands, good hand-to-eye coordination, able to catch the football. He's got the ball skills, too. Again, being able to track those punts is not easy. That's not for the faint of heart. So him to be able to track the punts, it shows you where his eyes are. He's got really good eyes. He knows how to track the football. He's really good in run support at 5'8". You know what I'm saying? At 185, he ain't the biggest dude in the world. But when it comes to run support, he's able to get busy. Okay, he's able to kind of lay that wood there. Pause. All right. So, and again, the punt return and kick return ability is going to be elite. He's probably the best in the entire class when it comes to returning punts and that specialist ability. So keep an eye on that, man. He's probably going to go higher based off of that alone and ability to play cornerback is going to be very, very good. All right. As far as weaknesses go, obviously he's going to lack the length. He's going to lack the size, the height. He's going to be a little bit smaller. So it's going to be difficult to he's going to be put in that slot cornerback box. Okay. Just it kind of is what it is. I think he's going to be a little bit older as well. He's 24 years old. He's going to be 24 years old at the start of the season. So he's going to he's going to have that age that may deter some teams that want that youth. You never know. And again, he's aggressive, sometimes a little bit over aggressive. You saw in some of these highlights, he gets his anticipation. Sometimes he gets a little bit too aggressive and quarterbacks could pick off that ability and he could get caught slipping on a slug or something like that. But yeah, man, I think this guy could end up going in the third round. And again, just because of that return ability, dog could go a little bit higher than that. But I really like what I see in Marcus Jones' game for sure. Moving on, coming in at number 8, we've got Marcus Emerson out of Mississippi State, 6'2", 200 pounds cornerback. Again, the coverage grade, 78.8, run defense, 74.2 grade, 0 interceptions on the season. That is a problem. I don't see the ball production skills that I'd like to see. We got to get those pass breakups. The forced incompletions are low as well. 2 of those. We got to get that up. So that's a little bit of a knock on him. I'm going to be honest with you. The ball skills aren't quite there. 58% completion percentage when thrown at. Passer rating is high as well. We'd like to get that lower. We want to see the passer rating come down. But the thing about him that is intriguing is his size, right? 6'2", 200 pound cornerback. That just those size cornerbacks just don't grow on trees. So when you look at his, you're really looking at him based off of what he could be, right? You're kind of projecting with Emerson. He's got a lot of experience at cornerback. Looking at the bottom of the screen there, again, 1,586 snaps at outside cornerback. But he's played a lot. He's played a lot of games since being a freshman. He played 13 games this past season, 49 tackles. But again, I like to see the ball skills improve. Probably not going to be the most athletic in the bunch, when it comes, but he's got the, he's gonna be able to dominate smaller wide receivers with that 6'2 frame. He's able to blitz off the edge as well. He's gonna take that physicality at the line of scrimmage. Really good in run support, as you saw just there. Again, he's able to trust his eyes, got good awareness. I think the thing with him though, which, and I think you're gonna hear a lot too as well with him, is that I think a lot of teams are gonna maybe wanna move him to safety. Because he is a big hitter. He's a very good tackler as well. He rarely misses tackles. He takes good angles. So people are going to look at that, and teams are going to look at that and be like, yo, we can move this cat to safety. So you may see that when it comes to Martin Emerson. But again, as far as weaknesses go, you know, the QB rating thing, when throwing at, I just he's not making enough plays on the ball. I think he's more so reacting to what he sees. And not being aggressive, right? Not using the instincts to kind of jump those routes. He's more just reacting. So I think, you know, his instincts got to get a little bit better. He's got to untrust his eyes and react. I don't know, but just keep an eye on that. Keep an eye on that. So again, overall, I think he's a tall cornerback that teams are going to want to see. All right. So I think you're going to see him go potentially in the third round. But again, if teams look at him as a safety, he could drop. All right. So he was originally recruited to be a safety as well, but then he dropped down to cornerback. So we'll see, man. We will see. But I think he could be a second day pick, and we'll see what happens with Martin Emerson. Coming in at number 7, we've got Kyler Gordon out of Washington, man. I don't know who the cornerbacks coach or the defensive backs coach is at Washington, but I'll be damned if they don't come out with some heat every single year. They've got guys. They've got a factory. I know some people don't really know about what Washington has going on, but if you look at what they put out into the league year in, year out, they might as well be called DBU. I know LSU has the moniker right now, but, yo, keep an eye on Washington, bro, because they got a couple guys in the top 10. He won't be the last one. Just a little sneak peek. But Kyler Gordon, 6 foot, 200-pound cornerback out of Washington. Solid player, man. This guy, again, looking at the coverage grades, 89.6, run defense 79.4, 2 interceptions, 51% completion percentage. That's about where you want to see it. A little bit lower would be great, but 50%, you want to give that, you know, 50% chance that you're going to make a play on the ball. Also, a 49 passer rating when thrown at, that's very good. Under 50 is solid for me. 6-4 incompletions, so I love that. And again, he's played some slot cornerback. He's also played outside cornerback. But I like this kid a lot, man. I like this kid. He only played 4 games in the COVID shortened season in 2020, but he broke out. He started all 12 games going back into 2021. 43 tackles. You see those 2 picks. He was also named to the All Pac 12 first team and won the Husky Excellence Award at University of Washington. All right, so that's pretty dope. As far as strengths and weaknesses go, man, he's got really good speed. All right, he's got elite quickness, elite speed, good like leaping ability. He's able to kind of be naturally cumbersome. Like, I don't know if that's a word, but he's able to blanket wide receiver. So he does a great job there. He's got good cover skills. You know, I really, really like, he's got a good IQ. He's got good aggressiveness. He's physical. He's able to shed defenders when getting to the football and run defense, excuse me. So he's very solid there. He's got really good cover skills. That's the name of the game. When it comes to playing cornerback, you've got to be able to cover. And that's what this kid can do. He's got really good cover skills. You know, he's got a really good, that vertical, bro. Watch him at the combine. Watch him at the combine, because in the past he had a 42.5 vertical, and bro, it's crazy. So keep an eye on that, bro. I think he has a background in dance, kung fu, ballet, all kind of stuff. So this guy's athletic, bro. Just keep an eye on this cat, man. As far as weaknesses go, sometimes he takes some bad angles. He does drop some catchable interceptions. I have seen that on film. I think you've seen that in the highlight here. You know, he could be a little over aggressive at times. You might see some penalties, but also at the same time, he's also had one good year of solid film, and that's going to be the latest. Your latest tape is going to be the best tape. All right. What you put out is a what have you done for me lately league. All right. So as long as it's what he was most recently done, I'm rolling. But again, he only has 1 year, a one solid year of good performance tape. All right. So again, athletic skills. He's going to be really good athletic. He's going to perform well at the combine, which could shoot his stock through the roof. All right. So that could happen. He could be a player that's going to be a solid contributor on the NFL roster day one if given the opportunity. I see him as a second round pick, maybe second to maybe early third round. We'll see what happens, but I really think his pro day and his combine film is gonna, or his combine tape is gonna really kind of shoot him through the roof, man. That the 40 times, all that stuff is gonna be solid for him. So let's move on. Oh, I didn't get my little thing there. But coming at number six, we got Roger McGary. Okay, Roger McGary out of Auburn. Very, very talented cornerback, man. I had a hard time placing him this low. I'm gonna be honest with y'all, man. This kid is special too, bro. He had a really good season this year. 6 foot, 190 pounds out of Auburn. Coverage grade of an 89.7. I think that's one of the higher grades. If you compare them all, he's up there as far as coverage grades. All right. I had a problem putting him in number six, but it's crazy. So run defense, 67.7. That could be where, you know, I kind of dropped him a little bit. Two interceptions, 45.3 completion percentage when thrown at, and a 57 passer rating also when targeted. But look at this. Forced incompletions in 2021, 20. 20 of them things. 20. That's a lot. That's a lot of forced incompletions, bro. That means he was getting busy. And he's playing in the SEC as well. So, bro, that's impressive. That is very impressive. Looking at his experience, 1,822 snaps at cornerback. That's our outside boundary cornerback. That is impressive, all right? That's very impressive. He started all 12 games this season. Again, 49 tackles, 2 tackles for loss. You see the interceptions. Again, he started getting attention this season, bro. This season, he broke out. He broke out a lot, had a very good season, all SEC recognition, and was named first team All-American by The Athletic and made ESPN and the Senior Bowl All-American team. So very, very good performance for his senior year. Let's jump into some of these highlights real quick for y'all, and I'll go over the strengths and weaknesses. Again, very solid measurables at 6 foot, 190 pounds. That's solid. I'm hearing the rumbles that he could run a 4.4 at the combine. Keep an eye on that. Good quickness, good smooth transition when the hips. He can flip the hips very well. He tracks the ball very well, which is very evident in the 20 pass breakups that he had, or 20 forced incompletions. All right, he's got really good anticipation. Again, what shows in the 20 forced incompletions, bro. He plays as if the football was thrown at him. It's almost like he was a wide receiver in the past. So he has really good ability, really good ball skills to track the football and make those reads. He trusts his eyes. So I love that. I love that. Love it. Love it. Love it. He reads the QB very well. And again, he's able to make those big hits. You know, quarterbacks may take advantage of that aggressiveness in the NFL. We'll see. Some of these quarterbacks in the NFL are very savvy. Could take hit you on that slug. I keep talking about that, but it could happen. He's got good speed, but not elite speed. Now he's not gonna have Derek Stingley speed, but we'll see what happens in the combine. But overall, I think this cat could move inside to slot or nickel. Again, he doesn't have a lot of reps there, but I think he could move into that position. Maybe slotted as a guy that moves into. Coming in number five, we've got Andrew Booth out of Clemson. 6 foot, 195 pounds. Man, this guy, man, is special. Special kid. Coverage grade of 78.6. Run defense grade of 72.3. This is where I had an issue. I really wanted to swap McGary and Booth, but man, some of the things I've seen from Booth, I was like, man, this is tough. All right, this is tough. 3 interceptions this season, 61.2 completion percentage when thrown at, 69.2 passer rating when thrown at or when targeted, 4 forced incompletions. again, a lot, most of experience came at boundary cornerback. So that's solid. Again, he in 2021, he played a nice amount of games, a really good player. You know, he had injury issues as a freshman. So again, some of the stuff that I seen, he flashed, bro. He's got really good ball skills, and we'll go ahead and jump into the strengths and weaknesses. But again, he's another guy that plays as if the ball was thrown towards him. This guy has elite ball skills. Okay, elite ball skills. He's got long arms, 32 inch arms that allow him to play bigger than his size. So he's got a good arm strength, good ability, good balance. He flashes as a physical hitter sometimes. He's got a good NFL frame, solid tackler. He's a guy that you might be able to put on the island and say, look, take this dude out the game. And I think he has that ability. Now, as far as weaknesses go, inconsistent getting off blocks, can be a step slow when it comes to you know, reacting to the quarterback. He doesn't have a terrible amount of experience. He's had some injury issues that has impacted his ability to stay on the field. So his experience is not as much. He doesn't have as much experience as other cornerbacks have in this class. So this is really a potential play. You have to go off the potential, and hopefully the injuries won't catch up to him, but they could in fact impact his draft stock. All right, but he has that potential to be a playmaker. He could struggle a bit early making that transition from college to the NFL with the lack of experience, but fam, I really think he could be a guy that's going to go in the second round. He could slide to the third based on the injury history, but if somebody goes off that potential, bro, and looks at that film, it could be one of those days where he could go as high as the first round. But again, it's one of those things that I had a hard time ranking him higher due to the experience and staying on the field. So that's my thoughts on Andrew Booth. Coming in at number four, again, another Washington cornerback. Whoever is managing the defense, or whoever is the cornerbacks or DB coach for Washington, they need to have an NFL job. Point blank, period. They're putting too much NFL talent. They have too many guys out here getting busy to not have those type of guys in the NFL. I'm sorry, but Trent McDuffie, 5'11", 195 pounds, coverage grade of 88.7, run defense grade of 78.4, one interception this year, 44% completion percentage when thrown at, passer rating of 52% when targeted, forced incompletions of 6. Again, a lot of experience playing cornerback, outside cornerback. All right, so again, he got first team All-American, all conference honors, Pac-12 coaches, Pro Football Focus, West Coast College Football, Associated Press, all kind of honors. Any kind of honor you want, you can think of, this man has got it. AP also named him to the third team of his All-American team for his impressive 2021 campaign. Very, very solid player. Very good player. Let's get into some of these highlights and talk about his strengths and weaknesses. Again, aware in the red zone. He's able to kind of, in that short area, he's able to really use his instincts and use his athletic ability to take away some of those fade throws. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes he makes quarterbacks throw the football late. Really good instincts. He's got the ability to read and react. Elite athletic ability. In high school, I think he ran a 4.47, 40-yard dash, 41-inch vertical. So this dude has some athletic ability that's going to flash at the combine. He's got really good quality backpedal, good balance, excellent mirroring ability, good football awareness, good tackler. He's a good tackler. Overall, just a very good, solid cornerback. As far as weaknesses go, obviously, again, we talk about the aggressiveness and being able to read and react. Sometimes you could be a little bit over aggressive, and then, you know, some guys, get caught slipping with that sluggo. Again, the size, right? 5'11", not a deal breaker. There's guys out there that playing at a great high clip at 5'11". So I'm not saying he can't. And 195 pounds, that's stocky. Like, he's strong, right? He's going to be able to to play strong on the boundary from those bigger wide receivers. All right, so again, could be a knock, but we'll see. You may hear rumblings of him getting moved inside the nickel or slot. You never know. But he's not going to have that elite arm length or ability to kind of wrap up some of these bigger wide receivers. So again, he might move. But again, I think he's very, very good player. Again, some people have him ranked in their top three. All right, some people have him ranked in their top three. I have him at four, just me personally. But I feel like in a man scheme, this guy could be a problem. You know, he's an elite prospect. He could be a lockdown cornerback at the next level. We'll see what happens. I think he's going to go in the first round. I'm quite sure he's going to go in the first round, late first round. Could slide into the early second, but we'll see. But very good player. Very, very good player, Trent McDuffie. Shout out to Washington and their DB coach, or whoever's managing that, because them dudes got some ballers. All right, let's move on. Coming in at number four, we've got Kyer Elam. This guy's, again, 6'2", 196 pounds. Very, very good player out of Florida. Coverage grade of a 58.1. This is due to limited snaps, but again, that's kind of the thing with PFF. But run defense, 77.1. One interception this year. 52.8 completion percentage when thrown at. 75.1 passer rating when thrown at as well. Five forced incompletions, but he's got a lot of experience playing outside cornerback. All right, a lot of experience playing outside cornerback. This guy, again, coming in 2021, which was his junior season, he had high expectations. He had some injury issues. He only had 27 tackles, but the injuries really kind of kept him off the field and kind of it limited his ability. I think he could have been higher on this list had he played a full season and been healthy. But again, solid player. Let's go ahead and get to some of these highlights while I talk about some of these strengths and weaknesses. It's got, again, ideal height, 6'2", 196 pounds. I mean, if you're drawing up a cornerback, that's what you're going to draw up in Madden, create a player. Okay, so that's the kind of player we create. So very good there. Actually a former wide receiver. That's, again, speaks to the ball skills. He is a former wide receiver. You watch that play right there, being able to stay with the wide receiver and track the football. Listen, he's got that ability. He plays as if the football was thrown for him. He's got a good vertical jump, tracks the football well, aggressive in coverage, got good top end speed, ran track in high school. He's aware in coverage. He's got a good feeling for the game. Again, looking at that play right there, he's got a good feeling for the game, good instincts, aware in the red zone. I just love what he brings to the table. Really good tackler as well. All right, as far as weaknesses go, just inconsistent, bro. Just been a little bit inconsistent. He got beat for two long TDs back in 2020. So again, sometimes it just gets beat. It is what it is. All cornerbacks get beat. It's just the name of the game. He has some injury issues with his knee. Again, we talked about that. The medicals are gonna have to check out the combine. That's just one of those things. One question I have is, can he stick with the quicker guys? Can he stick with those quick twitch guys? He's got good height and weight. But when it comes to those quicker guys, can he stick with those guys? But overall, man, I think that this guy is a very solid player. Again, he should go in the first. He should be a first day player. He really should be. But again, the medicals could drop him down. We'll see what happens. But I think he's going to be taken high. He's got to get consistent in NFL, though. He's got to develop that consistency. Be an every down guy. Be a guy that can be relied upon. On every down, and we not have to worry about him, you know, making mistakes. So, I mean, I know it happens to the best of them, but just working on that consistency is something he's going to have to work on moving forward and be an elite to be an elite player in the NFL. All right, moving on. Coming in at number two, I know this might surprise some of y'all, but coming in number two, I have Derek Stingley Jr. out of LSU, 6'1". 195 pounds. When you look at that coverage grade, 66.3. Run defense grade, 64.9. This year, I'm going to be honest with y'all. A lot of people were disappointed. He had some injury issues. He had a foot injury. He only played three games. All right. He only played three games. So a lot was left to be desired. Okay. So zero interceptions, completion percentage of 60%. Passer rating of 130.8 when targeted. So that's high. But again, there's limited film. for this particular season. All right. Looking at the outside cornerback, looking at the amount of snaps he's played, he's got a lot of experience. He does have a lot of experience, but you have to go back to his freshman year. You have to go back to his sophomore year to go back and see what Derek Stingley brings to the table. Okay, you got to go back to those to that tape. And again, when you cut on that tape, you see an elite level player. You see an elite caliber player. Okay. I mean, the strengths and weaknesses are through the roof. All right, let's go ahead and talk about it. The streaks, bro, the athletic profile of this man is going to be insane. When he gets to the combine, it's going to be a wrap. I'm hearing that he can run a 4.2. So when you have a guy that can run, a cornerback that can run a 4.2, and you got guys in the league like a Jalen Waddle, guys like a Tyreek Hill who are matchup nightmares due to the speed, and you can bring this guy and match up with those guys, that's what makes this guy so coveted and why a lot of people have him number one. The athletic profile alone is so good. All right. He's really, really good in coverage. Again, over the past 2 years, he's got one of the top rated cornerbacks, consensus, like across the board. A lot of people love what he does. He plays downhill. All right. So he's got good competitive spirit. He's going to be able to hit you. Good effective jam at the line of scrimmage, kind of knocks receivers off their block. Really, I'm telling y'all, man, he's aggressive when tackling. He's able to even give dudes a big cushion and able to close that gap very quickly because of his speed. That closing speed is insane. So when you talk about that, bro, this player has it all. Like, he has it all. All right. So the only thing, when it talks about these weaknesses, you know what I'm saying? It's tough. It's the injuries. The injuries are the huge name of the game, all right? One overall cornerback with the injury history, bro. I have to go back to his freshman year to really get that tape. Like, that elite tape, I got to go back to his freshman year. And I have a problem with that. Not to say that he's not going to be great, because he could potentially be awesome, right? It's just the athletic gifts are there. All pegs on the injury history. Does the medicals check out at the combine? If it does, it's through the roof, man. Through the roof. So shout out to Stingley, man. Again, great player. DBU, LSU, they putting out day in, day out, year in, year out. They putting out elite cornerback talent. So shout out to LSU. They earned a DBU moniker, but I'm telling y'all, Washington has something to say about that. But let's move on. Coming in at number one, I've got Sauce. Ahmad Sauce Gardner, okay? 6'3", 200 pounds, coverage grade of a 91.5, which comes in at the highest grade, the highest coverage grade there is for PFF for these cornerbacks. 76.8 run defense grade, 3 interceptions, 50% completion percentage, 26.1 passer rating when targeted. Let me repeat that, because I don't think y'all seeing that. 26.1 passer rating when targeted. That is effing incredible. 3/4 interceptions, and again, when you look at that that experience, a lot of experience playing boundary cornerback, and again, he never gave up a touchdown. Never gave up a touchdown, dog. So it's incredible. It's incredible, bro. Like, this dude is a monster. Again, this 2021 season was a problem. You know, 3 interceptions. He had 3 sacks as well, which are not on this list. You know, the PBUs that you know about. And the 21.6 passer rating is crazy. It's ridiculous, bro. It's ridiculous. This guy's a monster. And let's get to some of these strengths and weaknesses. Athletic, tall, he's gonna be a problem. Okay, he's gonna be a problem. Dominates tall, smaller receivers. Gonna be able to hang with the bigger receivers in the league. He never gives up on a play. He stays in the play. He's really solid in run defense as well. Tough tackler. He rarely misses a chance to make a stop. You know, he's aware. He can play in the zone. Good instincts. Good anticipation. It's just a really, really good cornerback that you can lock. He's a lockdown cornerback, man. You stick him. He's done it in college. You stick him on the other team's best receiver, and he eliminates him. That's what he does. And I think he can continue to do that in the NFL. Now, as far as weaknesses go, he's going to be a bit grabby. There's going to be some situations where he could get penalized. And, you know, it is what it is there. Now, another question mark is his speed. Now, we go from Stingley, who is great, elite speed cornerback. Then you go to Sauce, who doesn't have, he's probably not going to have the best 40 time. In fact, I'm seeing that it could be like a 4.5, 4.6, which is terrible. That's not, I mean, 4.6 is terrible. But what I see, it doesn't really translate to the film. Like, when I look at the film, he's got good game speed. And that's kind of what matters. If I was him, I probably wouldn't even run the 40, to be honest with you. If I know him, if I'm not going to run a 4.5 and I haven't tested out a 4.5, I wouldn't run because he can do more damage than good. But the game speed speaks for itself. So, again, I think really good player, bro. And again, I think he's probably not going to go higher than Stingley. But this is just my opinion. I feel like he is going to be a lockdown cornerback at the next level, bro. I think he could hit that Pro Bowl early in his career and be one of them dudes that you got to respect, okay? I'm telling y'all, 6'3", it's crazy. Now, if he goes out there and run a 4.4, he could challenge Stingley. He could challenge Stingley to be the top cornerback taken. But there's a lot of people that are on the fence with Sauce, okay? But again, I just, when I look at the film, I turn it on, I just think, bro, he's going to be really good. It's going to be really good, man. But again, like I said, I'm going to be honest. I do think Stingley goes ahead of him. But I'm going to roll with the fact that he still goes in the top 15. But that doesn't affect my rankings, right? My rankings don't necessarily go by draft position. It's just who I think is going to be the best out the bunch. That's just my opinion, all right? So, all right, that being said, man, that is my top 10. That is my top 10, man. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. Let me know what your top 10 looks like. Who am I missing? I know guys like Josh Job, y'all know how you pronounce his name. A couple other guys that we could potentially miss off of this list. But I like what I have. I'm confident about this. You know, Darion Kendrick, another guy who could potentially be on this list. But the cornerback is deep. That position is deep as well. So shout out to this cornerback class. And do me a favor. I work hard on these videos. It takes time, research. I put a lot of effort, the graphics, all that stuff. So do me a favor. Hit that like button, subscribe button. Help a brother out. Help us get to 50,000 subscribers. But that being said, man, I'm out. Peace.